Good morning, Ms. Kanchala.
Good morning, Mr. Phuodon and everyone. My name is Kanchala Kirati Ravi. I'm very pleased to be a co-MC today with you as well.
And on behalf of King Mongkut's Institute of Technology, Lat Krabang, Prince of Chung Kwan Campus, we appreciate you taking time out of your busy schedules to join us today. And we hope you find this program we have lined up for you to be fruitful and engaging.
Yeah, and that will be a brief of introduction of our institute for about 5 minutes.
Become an autonomous university under the supervision of the government since the year 2008. It intends to produce graduates of quality as well as integrity and to bring out research works and innovations of great value both at national and international levels to build up the body of knowledge for further development of the nation.
By implementing low-cost and high-technological teaching materials held at Novotel Chung Phan Beach Resort and Golf. On this occasion, may I invite the Acting Head of General Science and Liberal Arts Department, Prince of Chung Phan Campus, Mr. Sirisak San Sukhato, to deliver the reporting speech to the President of the opening ceremony, Professor Dr. Monai Grai-Rerk, Acting President of King Mongkut Institute of Technology, Lat Krabang. Please welcome Mr. Sirisak San Sukhato.
Thank you, Ms. Kanchala Kirati Ravi. The Acting President of King Mongkut Institute of Technology, Lat Krabang. My name is Sirisak San Sukhato, the Acting Head of Department of General Science and Liberal Arts. On behalf of the organizing committee of this international workshop in teaching and learning science and mathematics by implementing low-cost and high-technological teaching material, I would like to mention the objective of the workshop. First, to improve low-cost and high-technological teaching material in teaching science and mathematics. Second, to enable teacher, lecturer, and scientists to exchange knowledge in teaching and learning science and mathematics by implementing low-cost and high-technological teaching material. Third, to serve and support the ASEAN economic community. There are about 40 people attending this international workshop. Now, I would like to invite Professor Dr. Monai Grai-Rerk, Acting President of King Mongkut Institute of Technology, Lat Krabang, to give the opening speech of this international workshop in teaching and learning science and mathematics by implementing low-cost and high-technological teaching material. Please welcome.
In teaching and learning science and mathematics by implementing low-cost and high-technological materials, this workshop is a forum for scientists, teachers in science and mathematics to share information and earn new knowledge from excellent speakers in these 2 days. Actually, I wanted to explain about the history of KMITL, but in the video it already explained, so I will skip my talk about the university. And about the Chung Phan campus, which is located in Prathiu district of Chung Phan, it plays a key role in contributing to the higher education to the southern part of Thailand. And Chung Phan campus has a large area that can serve as a big laboratory for practicing and becoming a center of learning in the field of agriculture, food, and energy. So it is a big lab of KMITL. In this workshop, it is hopefully that the beneficial will be to the participant, and it is not possible without the great contribution from our distinguished lecturers, I would like to acknowledge Dr. Chanchai Ying Prayun, Professor Alexander Fishman, Professor Yoji Takikawa, Professor Sushaka Akaka, if I make mistake, my apology, Mr. Vasu Prakash, Professor C.S. Chow, and Ms. Li Jin Ong. And I also faithfully appreciate the support from not only from the speakers, but also from the organizing committee of the KMITL Chung Pon campus. On this auspicious occasion, I would like to declare opening this international workshop in teaching and learning science and mathematics by implementing low cost and high technological materials. I wish you all success and have a fruitful discussion. Thank you.
And first of all, I'd like to thank all the participants for being here for the seminar today. Before the first lecture begins, I'd like to give a brief overview of the program, which has been a little switched from the afternoon to this morning. From 9:30 at the schedule to 10:30, the first lecture presented by Professor Dr. Sudharakar Agarkar from India on the topic of science toys as teaching aids. And after a 15-minute break, there will be the second lecture presented by Mr. Vasu Prakash from India on the topic of salient features of Sri Prakash Educational Institution. And the next, the lecture presented by Ms. Li Jin Ong from Malaysia on the topic of creative play with the straw maze.
Okay, for the afternoon session, there will be a lecture presented by Professor Dr. Yoji Takigawa from Japan on the topic of exploring the world of light while making the marble protector. After the break, from 2 to 15, we will continue the workshop presented by Professor Yoji Takigawa again on his second topic of using a laser beam in teaching science and mathematics. And now, time to start the first lecture. May I introduce Professor Dr. Sudharakar Agarkar. Professor Dr. Sudharakar Agarkar received a PhD in science education from the University of Pune, India. Presently, he is associated with the Vidya Prasarak Mandal, then, or VPM, in the capacity as Dean VPM's Academy of International Education, the research. He's trying to establish network among academicians engaged in science, technology, and mathematics education in different...
To Professor Dr. Sudharakar Agarkar to help me welcome him to the lecture.
Ladies and gentlemen, during his preparation of the presentation, I would like to express my special thanks to the president of the King Mongkut Institute of Technology, Lat Kabang, for his very warm welcome, and also Professor Pachon Chai Saisit. Actually, we are all friends because I have been working here. It was 35 years ago.
I'm Professor Zhou. I come from Taiwan, and I major in physics. I truly hope that we have a nice experience of sharing what I have done in Taiwan with you guys, okay? Thank you so much.
I have been working with Professor Zhou for many years, okay? I met him first time in Guilin in China because I'm working as a visiting professor in Guilin in China. They call it Guangxi Normal University, okay? And my friend who went there said, okay, please work with us for a long term. And they asked him, why you call Normal University? And he said, well, actually, our university is normal, but the other are abnormal. But anyway, just a joke. And since then, we have been working together. And Mr. Vasu Prakash, please. My old friend. No, not long-time friend, not old friend. I mean. So he is, can introduce yourself, please.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Vasu Prakash from India. I'm the director of Sri Prakash Vidyaniketan School. We conduct science festivals in India. And that's how we are associated with Mr. Janchai. And we teach children from LKG to 10th grade. We are running our high schools there. We have four schools in with 4,000 children running in Visakhapatnam. It belongs to Andhra Pradesh state, belongs to India. Thank you.
Okay, and where are you? DJ Ong, maybe, yes. Not lady first, lady third.
Oops. Hi, I'm really happy to be here. I'm DJ Ong from Malaysia. I'm a founder and the curriculum director of Amazing Kids. It's a company that I started. So what I do is I develop and create and design preschool curriculums for Malaysian children. And we're also looking at going into the international market. So one of my hobbies really is also to do teacher training. So I'm really happy to be here to be with all of you. Thank you.
Thank you. You're the last one because you give the speech. Well, yeah. So I would like to introduce our guest speaker from Japan, Professor Yoshi Takikawa. Okay, he is very famous in Japan, and he has a television program and many things using low-cost material. I would like to introduce a little bit about him. You know Conan? He is the one. Okay. Okay. If you have a Conan book, ask him to sign, to give a signature on that. So he's an advisor of the Conan project. Maybe you can introduce yourself. He's from Tokyo.
Hello, nice to meet you. My name is Yoji Takikawa from Japan. And I'm now Tokai University in Tokyo. And at first I was a high school physics teacher, and after that changed to university. At first Tokyo University, and after that Tokai University. And Janchai, Mr. Janchai introduced me. Science Conan. Story is a detective story, but Conan uses science and finds the real things. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you. So actually, Conan, you know, there are many authors, but the science principle in that very fun thing is from him. So he's a great one. So before that, I would like to, yes, another one. Oh, my old friend. This is really old because we have been working together for 20 years. At that time, he has hair, black hair, me too. But now, gray hair and no hair. It's okay, Professor Alexander Fishman from Russia.
Thank you. I am very far friend of Janchai because I live maybe 10,000 kilometers from here, but we have very close relation with him. It's a very good friend. Thank you. At first, I would like to express my special son thanks for President Dr. Monet. I would like to give a little present for him.
Thank you. Okay, Professor Alexander. Yes. Alexander Fishman from Kazan Federal University, and he's, yes.
Okay. I'm professor of Kazan State University in Russia. This is one of the biggest university in Russia, Kazan. I will tell about this a little bit during my presentation.
Okay. And this workshop can be possible because of Professor Pachun Chai Chai said he's a vice president of this campus, and he organized all these things for you. We have been working together. Well, we got our PhD from Germany, the same university of Berlin. And yes, it's been a long time. Well, now I would like to pass my microphone to Professor. He's not ready, so I just keep talking. But okay, you ready?
Yeah. Okay, good morning to everyone. This is a very pleasant morning and a very good place to stay and interact with teachers. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to share my experiences of improving science education in India, which certainly would be of great help to you. As everyone has introduced themselves, let me also do it for myself. My first name, which is called given name, is called Sudhakar. Sudha is an elixir, and kar means hand. So here is a person who has an elixir in his hand. That is the meaning of Sudhakar. And Agarkar, in the state of Maharashtra, we have this special style of giving surnames. You might have known Tendulkar. Anyone very, very fond of cricket? No one here? Anyway. Gavaskar? No one here. Anyway. So those who are very fond of cricket know this name, because they are the two little masters who have created records in cricket. So this kar is basically mean my forefather were the residents of a place called Agar. That's how our names and surnames are derived. I am presently working at the Academy of International Education and Research. This is my second inning. I retired as a scientist at the Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, very famous institute, which conducts basic research in fundamental sciences. And after my retirement, I have joined this Academy of International Education and Research at a place called Thane. Thane is very close to the city of Mumbai. You can consider this as a part of Mumbai. And I am trying to not only conduct comparative research, but also trying to establish contacts between educators in different countries. As a part of that, I conduct educational tours of teachers to different countries. I have been taking teachers to UK, I have been taking teachers to Singapore, sometime I might bring teachers to Thailand, and have close interaction, because there is a lot that we can learn from each other. So instead of inventing a wheel, can we take it from someone who has already done it? That is basically the idea, and this is what I'm going to do. The title of my talk is, I have said low-cost activities to teach science. There has been some word, toys, etc. You might find toys inside here. But basically, the principle is called low-cost activities to teach science. You want to say something?
Okay, yes, yeah, sorry for that. Okay, so maybe I will give a short translation a little bit so that they can understand.
Because, okay, fine. Okay.
Professor Akaka. สุดาก็ความจริงแล้วเนี่ยชื่อนี้ก็เป็นชื่อสันสกฤตนะฮะค่าก็คือก่อนที่แปลว่ามือ actually your name we understand because it is from Sanskrit
yeah,
we call ก่อน but actually from Sanskrit okay we can understand each other and he's from Thane เป็นเมืองที่อยู่ใกล้เมืองมุมไบหรือเมื่อก่อนเรียกว่าเมืองบอมเบย์นะแล้วก็วันนี้ก็จะพูดถึงเรื่องการใช้อุปกรณ์ราคาถูกนะช่วยในการสอนวิทยาศาสตร์ Yes, please.
So I actually belong to Tata Industries, and I hope you will soon drive Tata Indica in Thailand. Fine. Let me now proceed and give you a little background. You see, this is true of many countries in Asia, that we teach science through words and by writing on the blackboard. This is the style of our teaching science. This is what we have also observed in India when I entered into this profession. You know, science teacher would come, try to explain what is written in the textbook, might give some examples, might perform some demonstration, and there is an attached laboratory program where you try to see, oh, whatever I have told you in the classroom, see, it's true here. Maybe it's law of mechanics, maybe it's a thermodynamics, maybe it's a rule of electricity, etc., etc. There is no fun. There is no enjoyment. There is no challenge in learning science. As a result, what is happening, the number of children coming to science is decreasing. Now in India, we have large number of research institutes, and you will find we are not getting young people for the research institute, even though we have such a big population, because they want to go to professional courses and other areas. And therefore, what we are trying to do is the science teaching in Indian school is done mainly through chalk and tap. Laboratory program associated with science teaching is used just to confirm what has been said in the classroom. There is hardly any fun in learning science. And because there is no fun, one is not motivated to learn. So what we have done, there are government agencies, there are organizations which are attempting to improve science education. They conduct teacher training, they develop curriculum, they write books, variety of things are being done. But you see, for teachers, unless someone comes and shows the activity, the teacher doesn't get motivated. Teacher need a direct support. And for that, what we have done is, we have established an organization called Kalyan Science Center. It's a volunteer organization. This is the place where I live. Kalyan is a town where I live. So we have, within that town, we have established this Kalyan Science Center, which is a voluntary organization made up of science teachers, science lecturers, some medical doctors, some philanthropic people, someone who has studied science some years ago, might be working in a bank. So all these people have come together and we have said, can we make science learning interesting? And by doing that, we have developed, we have designed a variety of low-cost activities to explain science concept in an interesting way. And not only we have developed, we have said, let us now perform. So using them, KSC, that is Kalyan Science Center, has been conducting workshops for school students for the last two decades. We started sometime in 1991 or so. Now it is almost 23 years that we have been doing. This is a voluntary work. This is not a part of my office work. The government doesn't pay me for this. This is a service to the society. And we have been doing this for students, as I told you. In the recent past, there has been invitation from different groups. There are many societies who invite us. There are groups of, you know, women's group called Mahila Mandal, etc., and engaged in spreading scientific literacy among the masses. And this presentation is based on workshops conducted so far in different parts of the state of Maharashtra. You might be knowing India is a very big country. So we have different states. On the northern part, it's a Hindi belt where Hindi is spoken. Then we have Gujarat. Then we have Maharashtra where Marathi is spoken. Then you come down, you have a Kannada. There is Karnataka where Kannada is spoken. Then you have Andhra Pradesh where Telugu is spoken. Then we have Tamil and Malayalam, all that. I come from the central part of India. If you look at Indian map, you will see Mumbai, which was called Bombay earlier, comes on the western coast of India. And the strip, which is central part of India, is the state of Maharashtra. We speak Marathi, and we do all this in Marathi. Explanation, conducting experiments, etc. Now I would like to show you what type of experiments we have.
Excuse me.
Look at this.
เขาบอกว่าในการสอนที่อินเดียนะครับครูก็สอนแบบช็อกแอนด์ท็อกครับก็แบบของเราเนี่ยฮะแบบโบราณเนี่ยนะนี่เขาก็พยายามที่เปลี่ยนแนวคิดว่าจะทำไงให้เด็กสนุกสนานโดยใช้อุปกรณ์ราคาถูกในการเน้นสนุกสนานแล้วก็มีองค์กรอิสระนะฮะที่มาช่วยด้านนี้ก็ทำให้เปลี่ยนแนวคิดไปนะฮะแล้วก็หลังก็ตัวหลังก็มีหลายองค์กรเข้ามาช่วยกันแล้วก็ งานที่เขาจะนำเสนอในวันนี้ก็ขึ้นอยู่กับเวิร์กช็อปที่เขาจัดจากที่ต่างๆเป็นตัวอย่าง Yes please
Thank you I hope you have said the same thing which I have said
Yeah but in short
Fine
How did you know that
Anyway now look at these items You have this straw which is bent here You have the plastic tube which has a hole here the hole here and this straw nothing has been done here here you can see where the small here hole here okay these are simple things and I am going to show you using this what type of activity you can do what he is doing is he is blowing air through the plastic tube and the bent tube is put on that plastic tube you can see this air when he is his father that was his son you can see he is blowing the air which is going here and passing through the bent tube but because bent tube has a cut on one corner it gives the rotational motion this is because of third law of Newton so Newton third law says if there is a action there is a equal reaction and in the opposite direction here what is happening the because the air is blowing in this direction the tube gets rotated what has been done is basically a muscle power converted into air blow that air blow is converted into a circular motion so this is what one can show how one energy gets converted into another energy using simple gadgets would you like to say something Janjay would you like to say
yes
something?
yes okay เขาใช้หลอดกาแฟนะฮะแล้วก็เป่าออกมาตอนนี้ตรงปลายเนี่ยมันก็จะทําให้มีลมออกมานี่ก็เหมือนกับจรวดน่ะลมออกมาปุ๊บมันก็จะขับเคลื่อนไปที่ตรงข้ามไอ้ make it shorter but the same meaning yes
fine good You are translating fast, fine. so let us now proceed and see something else. We have a similar gadget here, the same tube with a hole here, and we have the straw here, but the straw we have not bent. In the earlier experiment, we had bent the straw. In this experiment, we have a straight straw with a cut here, with a hole here, with yet another cut here. And the cut has to be on the opposite direction. If the cut is here, the cut is tube should be here. And you will understand why I am saying that. So you don't need my many things. These tubes you can obtain anywhere. These straws you can obtain anywhere. And you can use this even this glass tube is fine for us. And let us see how it works actually in the experiment. No sound?
Yes, yeah.
Is coming? Okay.
Can hear sound. ก็เป็นหลอดเจาะรูตรงกลางนะครับแล้วก็มีการเสียบแล้วตรงปลายก็ตัดปลายนะครับตัดปลายไม่ขีดปลายนะตัดปลาย ลมมันก็จะผ่านรูตรงกลางออกไปสองข้างครับเนื่องจากมันไม่บาลานซ์มันก็เลยทำให้มันหมุนได
้And because there is a cut in the opposite direction, once again the same principle remains the same, but this can be shown in a interesting manner with very little expenditure. The entire focus is on spending a little, because you know we are not that rich. Let us accept this. Even though some of us might be spending a lot of money driving a car, as a country we are not rich. And we cannot afford to have. Sorry, what has happened? We cannot afford to have very big, sophisticated laboratories. And because we cannot afford to have laboratories, we cannot say because we don't have a lab, I am not going to perform the experiment. And even if we have a lab, what happens is I can have 2-3 beakers, which I will not be able to supply. I might have just one Van de Graaff generator, which I will not be able to give to everyone. So in order to make it available to everyone, such low-cost things are to be done. Interestingly, they explain the principle. It is not that you are doing something different. You are explaining the same principle using low-cost material.
Wonderful.
Now I have another gadget. This is a thermocol piece. Thermocol, I hope everyone knows, which is used for packing of the things. Whenever we buy anything, maybe it's a television set or a radio set or a mixer, whatever thing we bring nowadays in the box, there's a thermocol inside. And the thermocol is used as a packing material. And in our country, we use this for a variety of purposes. Now this is a thermocol piece, a rectangular piece. What has been done is this is a thread put here. You can see this is not straight. This is on one corner. It has been put here like this. This is also here and on one corner. So here you will see it is broadened, here it is shortened. Okay? And just making this arrangement, let us see how one type of motion gets translated into another type of motion. And this is what we are going to see. So, this and that is created. Okay, he is, you can see he is giving a sort of a rotational motion, and this gets translated into translation motion. See, I think this is fine. After he has done this, I have requested him that he does it horizontal. Okay, so when I requested him to do it horizontal, you see even it gets moved horizontally. And here you can see which part is which direction. I think when I touch this, there is some problem anyway.
ไม่จำเป็นต้องเป็นแนวตั้งก็ได้แนวนอนก็ได้นะครับก็อาศัยหลักการ
Once again, you will find that this is a very low cost. What you need is a thermocol piece and it could be even a thick cardboard will work and a thread and a little ingenuity to put that thread into the thermocol, and then you can show this how one type of motion gets translated into. Fine. I will now proceed and show you something different. Now, from the time I have come to Thailand, I have been observing that we have all these glass bottles. In India, we have these plastic bottles. And then there is a cap here. And this plastic bottle can be cut anywhere you want. So what we have done is, we have cut the plastic bottle here. By cutting the plastic bottle, I get the bottom part, and I get the upper part with a cap. So cap part, we have converted this into this fan. Not working, fine. I think my hand will better. Okay, you have converted this into the fan, like this. This you can understand, this is inverted bottle. Assume that I have cut this bottle somewhere here. The lower part is kept here. Okay. The upper part has been converted into the fan, and you can see the lid, the cover lid there. Okay. Now, this is just a throwaway bottle. You can get such bottles anywhere. If I am walking from my house to the station, I can collect about 20 such bottles any day. There is no problem of, there is no dearth of such bottles available on the streets. Okay, now doing that, let us see what type of activity we can do. Now the question is, who is rotating? It is a fan that is rotating. It is a fan that is giving air to this fan and therefore is rotating. Now interestingly, you can also observe the direction of the fan above and the direction of the fan below. That is opposite to each other. And you don't have to do much. You have to just convert this into pieces. As the air blows, it gets circulated and you can have a very interesting demonstration. If you want something more to be done, what you can do is you can put water into that, a colored water. You put colored water here and as the fan rotates, the colored water gets spread. Okay? Of course, you have to worry about the children sitting nearby you. But it doesn't, of course, it's a sort of a spray. It's a sort of a shower that is created.
ก็ใช้ขวดน้ําดูดนะที่ไม่ใช้แล้วเนี่ยมาตัดเป็นแจกๆเป็นใบพัดนะฮะแล้วก็ตัวนี้อันนี้ก็สอนเรื่องอะไรก็บอกว่าไอ้ตัวนี้หมุนได้เนี่ยมันต้องมีพลังงานทําให้หมุนแล้วพลังงานที่ทําให้หมุนนี่ก็คือพัดลมข้างบนนะก็คือการถ่ายเทพลังงานจากข้างบนลงมาข้างล่างนะก็สอนเรื่องเกี่ยวกับการอนุรักษ์พลังงานก็ได้นะฮะอีกอันนึงก็พูดถึงเรื่องของการหมุนของพัดลมพลาสติกเนี่ยกับพัดลมตัวบนเนี่ยมันหมุนคนละทิศทางกัน เพราะว่ามีการถ่ายเทพลังงานออกมาเพราะฉะนั้นต้องพูดถึงเรื่องของโมเมนตัมด้วยนะเกี่ยวข้องมันจะคนละทิศทางกันถ้าใส่น้ำสีเข้าไปเนี่ยน้ำก็จะกระเด็นออกมานะครับ
See, when we actually conduct this workshop, we bring such bottles. In fact, we ask the children to bring bottles and they are given the cutters and everyone does this. It's not only one person doing and demonstrating. Here, for the convenience of demonstration and for the convenience of explaining my point, I am using the PowerPoint. In actual practice, we make the children do this. It, of course, takes little time. And, you know, every child is not now habituated to cut the things. Now our children, the next generation, is more habituated to computers. They would like to do something on the computers. As our childhood was, they are not habituated to work by hands. And therefore it takes time for us to explain to them how to cut this, etc., etc. But we make them do it. Once they do it, they want to take it home. Every child takes this home. It becomes the property of that child. And once the child goes, that person wants to show it to family members and friends and become a star after going back to
ก็คือการทดลองแบบนี้ไม่ใช่เป็นการสาธิตอย่างเดียวก็ให้เด็กลงมือทำด้วยก็คือ hands on เสร็จแล้วเนี่ยพอทำเสร็จปุ๊บเนี่ยเด็กก็จะรู้สึกภูมิใจแล้วก็เอากลับบ้านกลับบ้านก็ไปสนุกกับครอบครัวแล้วก็ไปบอกคนอื่นต่อไปก็เป็นการเผยแพร่ความรู้ทางวิทยาศาสตร์กระจายไป
Okay, this was an example of a circular motion getting translated into circular motion. So what has been done is there was a circular motion of the fan. With the blow of air, it was translated into circular motion, but it was much interesting to see. We will now have a look at another experiment where I am trying to translate the linear motion into circular motion. What I need is a rod. This is actually an aluminium rod. Once again, a straw. The straw is cut into small fans, you can see. Small pieces have been cut. So this is like a fan, and I would like to show you actually what happens with this gadget.
ทดลองเกี่ยวกับการเคลื่อนที่แบบหมุนนะครับก็มีลวดรู้สึกจะเป็นซี่ลวดจักรยานนะฮะอันนี้อาจารย์ใช้ลวดอะไรก็ได้มาตัดตรงงอตรงปลายแล้วก็ใช้หลอดกาแฟมาตัดให้เป็นแจกๆ แล้วก็สวมลงไปแล้วก็เคาะเคาะตรงนี้ก็คือการถ่ายเทพลังงานนะโดยผ่านเส้นลวดก็ทําให้เนื่องจากหลอดที่มันไม่สมดุลนะมันก็จะมีการเอียงกิ่งเมื่อเราเคาะพลังงานเราก็เคาะไปเรื่อยๆพลังงานก็ถูกถ่ายทอดไปมันก็จะมีการส่งพลังงานต่อไปก็จะมีการหมุน
Yeah. What this boy is doing is giving jerks, which is basically a linear motion, and it is getting converted into a circular motion. And you can see the things used are so simple and easy, which you can obtain anywhere. Fine. Let us.
May I add up something? Well, the application of this is if you want to open the bottle and it's very tight,
yeah.
What we can do is we use the spoon to hit a little bit so that we can give energy to open.
Yeah.
หลักการนี้ที่เอาไปประยุกต์ใช้งานก็คือบางทีขวดแน่นแล้วเปิดไม่ออกเนี่ยก็อาจจะใช้ค้อนนี่เคาะเบาๆก็มีการส่งผ่านพลังงานก็ทำให้ฝาเนี่ยค่อยๆคลายเกลียวออกมา
Yeah, good. Thank you for this. Okay, let us now move ahead. Here I have a very simple instrument that we will see. I have not shown it separately. I will directly show the activity and then explain what does it mean. You can see there are two plastic cups attached to each other in the inverted format. And what this boy is doing is he has the rubber wound around it and he is giving the motion. This has been done in a house where there are a lot of produce. You can see me standing there. So what he is doing, this is, you know, whenever we have to give a circular motion, this is what you do. This is how you move the top also. But here, instead of doing it on the surface, we are using the air. And you can also see the path of the dumbbell shaped object. It comes down. And not only comes down, it comes rotating. Mm. It doesn't just fall down. It comes rotating. And depending on how much space you have, you can even take it at a longer distance. Depending on how much rubber you have, you can provide more energy. It is basically the conversion of static energy into dynamic energy. You are converting static energy that is put into the rubber band, which you just pull and leave it and convert into dynamic energy.
Okay. หลักการนี้ก็เกี่ยวข้องกับหลายเรื่องนะวิธีการก็คือใช้ถ้วยกระดาษหรือถ้วยพลาสติกเนี่ยประกบติดกันแล้วก็ใช้ถังสติ๊กเนี่ยพันนะครับแล้วก็ยิงออกไปก็คือการเปลี่ยนแปลงพลังงานที่หนังสติ๊กที่เราพันเข้าไปคือพลังงานสัตว์ที่สะสมไว้พอปล่อยมาปุ๊บมันก็จะกลายเป็นพลังงานจลนะก็คือพลังงานจลของการเคลื่อนที่พลังงานจลของการหมุนในขณะเดียวกันพอมันหมุนปุ๊บมันก็เกิดแองกูลาร์โมเมนตัมก็ทำให้มันทรงตัวอยู่ได้ไม่พลิกนะรู้จักหนังสติ๊กไหมอาจารย์หนังสติ๊กเนี่ยหลายคนเข้าใจผิดนะคิดว่ามันเป็นยางเอกชนแต่จริงไม่ใช่มันเป็นยางรัด
Good Thank you
ยางรัด
What did you say
It's a Thai joke about the rubber band
What's the Thai joke
Well it's a word playing
Okay Fine Now we move to we are still in the concept of mechanics because these are the concepts which can be explained very easily through variety of activities. Here there is another activity which I will show first in the fast motion and then in the slow motion. Here I would like to show you what it is. This is a boy, he has a pencil in his hand, the pencil by which we write, has a pencil in his hand and he has a thread like this, a longer thread. Of course it could have been colored but we could not do that, it would be fast. Here there is a ball, here there is a small disc. So the weight of the disc is very small as compared to the ball. So ball is heavier. So as he would leave this, because of the weight of the ball, the thread should come down. That's what we expect. And let us see what happens when he does this. Ready? It doesn't go down. It gets circulated. Let us see once again and then I'll show you in the slow motion. Ready? You know, the other thread gets wound around this. And you might appreciate this in the second case. This is slow motion. You see, this thread is coming. That's how it does. Now you can, depending on what is your topic, you can discuss it. It could be angular momentum. It could be potential energy, whatever topic you want to use it for, depending on your interest, your topic of discussion, you can see this in slow motion. I hope you can see this, the thread getting wound around the pencil. Everyone can see this? Everyone can see this? Not so the thread wound around the pencil?
Not so clear, but huh? I can see a little bit. But
you can see?
At the back, I don't know what.
This is what I'm saying. And just ask them whether they can see this. You know, this thread, which he leaves, as soon as he leaves, coming like this.
มีได้แล้วมีลูกตุ้มนะปล่อยมาปุ๊บมันก็จะมีการหมุนแกว่งไป
yeah.
พันรอบๆนิ้วเนี่ยนะก็สอนเกี่ยวกับเรื่องของการหมุนได้ตอนแรกก็มีการหมุนช้าเป็นวงกลมหมุนช้าแล้วมันก็จะเร็วขึ้นเรื่อยๆเรื่อยๆเพราะว่ารัศมีของการหมุนเนี่ยมันสั้นลงตามหลักการ
yeah.
ส่ง
yeah.
โมเมนตัมเชิงมุม
finish so okay yes. so we have done so many activities for mechanics let us now convert this into something different
การทำให้เกิดเสียงมีหลายแบบ Let me ask them what is sound เสียงคืออะไรครับอาจารย์ใครตอบได้เสียงก็คือสิ่งที่นักการเมืองต้องการเวลาเลือกตั้ง sound something about
sound?
Sound yes
okay. No, of course, this was, you can see this video was taken at home. You can see Lord Ganesha's picture in behind. We worship Lord Ganesha before beginning any activity. And every year we have this Ganesh Chaturthi, which is about 10 days festival, which is a very big festival in the state of Maharashtra. So you will find Ganesh idols in every houses. Anyway, so what I was trying to show you here, and firstly, let me tell you what this person has. This person has a thread, and to the thread, what he has attached is a 6-inch scale that you find in the compass box, which you will be able to see it here in the slow motion. And that, let me first show you slow motion, and then you can see this. Yeah. So he has this scale, which is rotating, but in slow motion there is no sound. Sound will be produced only when there is a certain frequency. Because when is sound produced? Sound is produced when there are vibrations created. It's a 6-inch. Yeah. It's a 6-inch scale, 6-inch scale which is in the compass box. And you have attached it to the thread, and you are just rotating it. And you can, let me stop this and go to this, you will find. This is faster, because it is faster. And doesn't matter what you connect. We have connected the plastic scale, half a foot scale, because it can give vibrations. It could be even wooden scale, doesn't matter. Even metallic is fine. But it is just a strip of, say, thermocol. It might not work because the vibrations would not be created. You can try out whichever you want. It could be a metallic strip. But only thing is you will have to give a motion which is faster. And as I told you, if it is slow, the sound will not be produced. It's doing the same thing, but the sound is not produced. Because there is no vibrations created, enough number of vibrations.
การกำหนดเสียงนะเสียงก็คือพลังงานรูปหนึ่งซึ่งเกิดจากการสั่นสะเทือนของวัตถุนะก็สามารถทำได้หลายอย่างวิธีหนึ่งก็คือมีท่อนะเจาะรูแล้วก็ทำให้มีการเคลื่อนที่นะรูปเมื่อลมผ่านท่อเนี่ยมันก็จะเกิดการสั่นเกิดเสียงขึ้นมานะก็คล้ายๆหลักการของผมไม่ทราบเด็กรุ่นใหม่รู้จักว่าวดุ่ยๆไหมเป็นว่าวแล้วก็มีเนี่ยพอขึ้นไปข้างบนโดนลมปุ๊บมันดุ่ยดุ่ยดุ่ยดุ่ยนะฮะหรือว่าลูกข่างของพวกชาวเขานะฮะที่เจาะเป็นกลมๆพอลมหมุนปุ๊บเนี่ยมันก็จะเข้าไปมันก็จะดังวู๊ดขึ้นมานะครับ
โอเค now we go to another activity where once again the sound is being produced I'll show you what it is he has a thread here and this threads have knots because threads have knots as he pulls there's a little obstruction created here is theMetallic thing which I'll show you in the slow motion and it goes on striking. Let me show you in the slow motion, that will be much clearer. Of course,
นะครับผูกเป็นปมเป็นปมนะแล้วก
็
นิ้วรูดจะให้เป็นปม
This is a metallic knob that we have on any bottle okay and this is a thread which has knots and this is small disc so that another thread is connected here and what happens is as he's pulling at every knot stops and therefore it touches and every touching see you can see every touching creates the sound now because it's in slow motion the sound is not being heard here but there you hear the sound
but a wand is not นะฮะร้อยด้วยหนังสติ๊กแล้วก็ติดกับแท่งโลหะแท่งน็อตเนี่ยแล้วพอก็ต้องเชือกเป็นปุ่มๆถ้าเราลูดลงมาปุ๊บเนี่ยมือมันก็จะไปโดนปุ่มแต่ละปุ่มนะฮะแล้วก็ดังสติ๊กก็จะดีดกับเป็นเสียงความถี่มันขึ้นอยู่กับความเร็วที่เราลูด
Fine let's now move and have some fun with the whistles
อันนี้ก็เป็น
So this is a person who helps me in these activities in fact he came last time when we came to Pattaya this time he could not come
อันนี้เป็นเครื่องช่วยเสียงเวลาแห่บวชนาคนะฮะก็ไม่ต้องนั่นมากนะโอ้ยโอ้ยโอ้ยโอ้ยช่วยได้เยอะนะครับโอ้ยโอ้ย
See this is the plastic bottle that I was referring toWhich we have cut for the earlier experiment, and Bisleri is a company which produces bottled water, and they earn a lot of money. They have not given me any money to advertise their name. coincidentally, the bottle that was available was Bisleri. But you can see what has been done. Here is a bottle. The knob has been removed, and after removing the knob, this balloon is fitted, and this balloon is to be fitted in such a way that.It touches here. If you have a balloon this way, then the sound will not be produced. And then this balloon here is for convenience of blowing the air. He has a tube which is connected to the balloon. What this person is doing is blowing the air, and by blowing the air, he is ensuring that vibrations are created here. Unless we have a small opening.Vibrations will not be created. If you have a big opening, vibrations will not create, and then sound will not be produced. And as you move, variety of sound is produced, and you can then discuss the production of sound. One can even make some fun by tapping it here. You can do a variety of things.
การก็คือเอาขวดน้ำเปล่ามานะครับเอาฝาออกแล้วเอาลูกโป่งเนี่ยที่ปลายติดกับท่อเสียงมาครอบลงไปทีนี้ถ้าหากว่าเราเป่าปุ๊บเนี่ยพอลูกโป่งมันตึงเนี่ยมันก็จะปิดรูลมออกไม่ได้ต้องยืดเข้ายืดออกหน่อยนะให้ลมผ่านออกมาได้เพราะลมผ่านออกมาปุ๊บมันก็จะเกิดการสั่นสั่นมากสั่นน้อยขึ้นอยู่กับความตึงของลูกโป่ง
โอเค when father did this his son said I have another simple whistle and I'll show youYou know what he did? He used this. He had a small plastic bottle, created a hole and has a pipe, plastic pipe introduced. There's another plastic pipe and of course rubber is put on the upper part of the bottle. You need rubber to create vibrations. And let us see what type of sound he produces.
กล่องพลาสติกนะครับแล้วก็ต่อเข้ากับหลอดกาแฟและข้างบนก็เป็นแผ่นกระดาษหรือเป็นแผ่นฟิล์มบางๆเมื่อเป่าพวกก็จะทำให้เกิดการสั่นเกิดเสียงขึ้นมา
อ So here you can see what has been done. These are the throwaway plastic bottles that we get, especially when we buy medicines or something like that. And two tubes, it could be plastic tubes, glass tubes, whatever it may be. We have to create two holes and just a balloon. A balloon is available anywhere so cheaply. And what one does is what one puts the balloon on the top, blows air through one tube, and because there is a balloon, there are vibrations created. The important thing of producing any sound is that vibrations are to be created in the air. Whenever there are vibrations created, there is a sound. When I am speaking, what I am doing? I am actually creating vibrations here. And these vibrations are falling on this microphone, which are getting converted into electrical signals, which are then reconverted into sound waves at the loudspeaker. Even when there is a lightning, what happens? Because of the lightning, the air through which the lightning goes expands fast, and then there is a expansion and rarefaction. As a result, you get that big sound in the during the lightning.
การสะเทือนวัตถุในที่ก็คืออากาศที่มีการกระเพื่อมไปมาเงี้ยก็เหมือนกับฟ้าแลบฟ้าแลบปุ๊บเนี่ยสายฟ้ามันก็ทำให้อากาศเนี่ยร้อนอย่างรวดเร็วก็มีการขยายตัวแล้วกดเข้ามานะบางคนอาจจะสงสัยว่าทำไมเห็นแสงกับได้ยินเสียงไม่พร้อมกันเพราะอะไรครับเราเห็นแสงก่อนนะสายฟ้าแลบแล้วยินเสียงไม่พร้อมกันเพราะอะไรเพราะว่าตากับหูนั้นอยู่คนละที่พูดเล่นโอเค
Here is another activity, once again related to sound, but it's something different. Not many things. No tube, no balloon, only the straw. So he is blowing through the straw. I'll show you how, what he has done. And he is going on cutting. Because he is going on cutting, the sound changes. I hope you are, those who have learned physics must have learned the principle of resonating tube. Whenever there is a certain air column, that resonating tube gives you a specific sound, sound of a specific pitch. When the air column decreases, you can see, it's cutting, the pitch has changed, it's cutting further, the pitch has changed. And he would have, yeah, sure. See, what has been done is only this small cut on the straw. Not a very big activity that one has to do. And then produce sound and go on creating various pitches
on this. ท่อยาวไม่เท่ากันเนี่ยมันก็จะทำให้เกิดเสียงไม่เท่ากันเพราะว่าเป็นท่อกำถอน resonant หรือท่อกำถอนเนี่ยความยาวไม่เท่ากันก็ให้เสียงที่ต่างกัน
Yeah Okay we have done so much about sound let us now do something about surface tension and absorption It was a very simple activity that this man is performing What he has done is he has taken a piece of newspaper and he has folded into in such a way that it is flattened. So he has put four folds and the paper is flattened. Now that flattened paper I have requested him to put on the surface. It's a table, plastic table. Nothing happens. Then this person is putting the same here in water. And you see what happens.
เรื่องเกี่ยวกับแรงตึงผิวนะครับแล้วก็เรื่องเกี่ยวกับการขยายตัวของวัตถุเมื่อได้รับความชื้นแล้วก็มีกระดาษพับเนี่ยนะฮะแล้วก็มาวางลงในน้ำนะพอน้ำได้รับน้ำซึมเข้าไปก็ทำให้กระดาษเนี่ยขยายตัวออกมา
There is no harm in trying because there is no danger here. And you don't need much on the surface, it doesn't happen. On the water, And once again, as I told you, depending on what concept are you teaching, you can use these activities. Of course, you have to choose the relevant activities for a concept. You can see, and when it opens, wow. You are all because adults, you see. Children don't keep quiet. They say, oh, very good, wonderful, can I do this? No, adults keep quiet. Oh, it's fine. Going ahead, that's all. So let us see one more time and then move to the other
activity. การพิจารณาเสนอว่ากระดาษเนี่ยใครต้องการส่งจดหมายรักเนี่ยนะก็เขียนนะแล้วก็ปิดไว้แล้วก็ไปบอกส่งให้ผู้หญิงบอกเธอไปดูนะถ้าไปอ่านในน้ำนะผู้หญิงก็รับไปปุ๊บเนี่ยก็เนื้อเป็นเศษกระดาษก็วางไว้ไม่บอกว่าคนอื่นก็เอาไปอ่านนะ
So what is the explanation for this? See, when I have put this in water. Water, you know, the bottom part gets wet and then slowly the water percolates. This might not work if you have a bond paper. This has to be a porous paper where the water would rise into. You might try this with a bond paper and you might find it doesn't work.
What's the duty? อมน้ำได้นะเพราะดูน้ำเพราะมีขยะเหมือนกับประตูไม้บ้านเราเนี่ยนะประตูไม้เนี่ยเพราะวันไหนที่ฝนตกมากๆเนี่ยมันจะปิดยาก like a wooden door rainy day difficult to close
it becomes thicker in the winter okay let us proceed further and see one more interesting activity which I am sure we will like if you like say warm
ก็คล้ายๆกันนะใช้ไม้จิ้มฟันนะ
What we have done is we have taken 5 toothpicks you can have 6 4 whatever you want they have been bent in the middle and they have been arranged in such a way that this is type of figure is created and what this man is doing is putting water just water no magical water simple drinking water You can see they are coming closer they have come closer just by putting a drop of water and the surface is not magical it's a tile it's a black tile you can see and now not only they have come closer they are expanding so it will now get converted into a star you can see it's now expanding
ทางไปเรื่อยๆนะฮะทำเป็นรูปดาวบ้านเราก็เล่นนะเด็กผู้ชายเล่นทะลึ่งเนี่ยนะฮะใช้อันเดียว
So what we have done let me once again show this repetition for understanding so he has arranged this in such a way that there is a very small gap at the center and he is putting the water drop at the center and you can observe the movement
is integration of art and science
I can see they are coming you can see it very clearly they are coming closer they have already come they are coming closer they are coming closer now then this is the last chance they are lazy like me so it takes time and therefore and after that once they have come closer they start expanding very interesting to watch and as I was telling you every child can perform this it's not necessary that only one person has to perform even though for simplicity for convenience I am doing it with the help of projection everyone can do it what you need is just a surface where water would spread it could be marble it could be tile or whatever it could be and most of the houses now have tiles and marbles and this is how the star is created and then you can explain this to a phenomena of surface tension and how it works etc let us go to another activity this is an activity connected to a candle and as I was telling you I am fond of conducting such demonstrations some years ago I conducted a demonstration on chemistry of candles you might be knowing the great Michael Faraday conducted this demonstration in 1860 at the Royal Society of London 1860 150 years ago I repeated the show I could not of course imitate the Michael Faraday exactly but I conducted the entire show on candles. Very interesting show. We might have it sometime later. This is a very small part of that show. Here I am using the principle of center of gravity. I wanted to show that this is the water. The candle can continue burning in water. That's the point I wanted to make. And how? And in order to do that, you want to translate?
Yes. เขาจะพูดถึงเรื่องของ เทียนไขนะก็เอามาจากการทดลองของ Michael Faraday มีหนังสือเล่มหนึ่งที่ Michael Faraday เขียนไว้ในศตวรรษที่ 19 ที่แล้วนะผมก็มีอยู่เล่มหนึ่งข้างในก็มีเรื่องราวที่เกี่ยวกับการทดลองด้วยเทียนนะที่สนุกมากถ้าอาจารย์สนใจก็อาจจะก็คอปี้ก็ไม่ดีนะคือมี copyright นะแต่ว่าทําเป็นคอปี้รองก็แล้วกันตอนนี้ก็เอาการทดลองนั้นมาทดลองแล้วก็ไปโชว์ตามที่ต่างๆก็ประสบความสําเร็จ Yes please
Yeah. You might be knowing Michael Faraday did not have much education. He had only a school education. And he entered into Royal Society as a laboratory attendant and retired as the president of Royal Society.
Michael Faraday didn't have any education. If he was in our house, he would have been working at Sea Lock. He would have been able to read the book of the book of Sir Humphrey Davy. He would have been able to read
And he was concerned that the science should be given to the common people. So he started Friday lectures. These are called Faraday's Friday lectures. And chemistry of candle. He gave three lectures on chemistry of candle in 1860. Anyway, this is only a part of that. See what we are doing. Candle is made up of wax. Wax has a density which is very much equal to water. Little less than that. Therefore, what happens whenever you put candle, it flattens. What we have done is we have put a little pin here. By putting that pin, I can keep the candle straight. And what was the purpose of doing this? Purpose of doing this that I can, now this is what it happens as one puts the candle. But then after putting the needle, it goes. And what we have done is, we have lighted this wick. And this continues to burn until the candle exists. That is interesting. So this candle burns within water. Why? Because as the candle burns, it goes up. It comes up. It comes up. It comes up. And it continues to burn until the end of the wax. So here I am using this for adjusting center of gravity. Because what I have done is we have just tried to bring the center of gravity little down. Earlier it was getting flatter. Now I have tried to bring the center of gravity little down by putting a needle and therefore I can make it straight.
Okay? Center of gravity ปกติเทียนไขเนี่ยมันก็จะมีความหนาแน่นใกล้เคียงกับน้ำเหลือจะน้อยกว่านิดนึงมันก็จะลอยได้นี่ทำยังไงที่จะให้มันเทียนตั้งคือเอาเข็มเนี่ยเสียบตรงก้นนิดนึงแล้วก็ให้มัน ดิ่งลงมาเพื่อที่จะเปลี่ยนจุดศูนย์ถ่วงนะพอดิ่งมาปุ๊บเนี่ยปลายมันก็จะโผล่น้ำนิดนึงก็จุดเทียนก็จะติดนะอยู่ในน้ำนะเสร็จปุ๊บเนี่ยพอเทียนเผาไปเรื่อยมันก็จะเปลี่ยนจุดศูนย์ถ่วงไปเรื่อยแล้วมันก็จะโผล่ขึ้นมาเรื่อยก็ทำให้หลายคนรู้สึกประหลาดใจได้
Okay, I am now going to show you something which Michael Faraday did not do 150 years ago.
Yes.
150 years ago, he did not think of this because he focused on chemistry. I am focusing on physics of it. This is a candle. You know, on one side, there is a wick, always. On the other side, it is flattened. What we have done is we have tried to bring out the wick on both sides and lighted the wick on both sides. And firstly, we had a center of gravity adjusted. There's a toothpick inserted, and based using that center of gravity, this has been kept horizontal. Now, because we have lighted these two, what happens is, when the drop falls down, it becomes lighter, goes away. When the wax drop falls down, it becomes lighter, goes away. And this dancing of a candle, I told you, and I hope Michael Faraday will be happy that someone has added one more experiment to candle. He of course he did not do, he did something else. Of course it doesn't mean his work was less important, but this I thought I should add since we are referring to center of gravity and we are also referring to the movement. This is what is seesaw. In seesaw, what happens? When you have a seesaw, boy with a little weight is sitting here, the boy with heavier weight, it goes down, comes up. Then someone else comes, sit, come, goes down, and then this goes up. And that's how you have the seesaw, depending on the weight which side it is. And this is once again a simple experiment where candles can be obtained at any place. You can use either a needle or a toothpick, whichever you want. The platform, these were the glasses in my house, so very simple. You can use any platform. It's not a cup, whatever it may be. Any platform is okay. Wooden platform is fine. And one can continue. And this continues as long as the candle is burning. Very interesting experiment, which the children enjoy.
ฟังเสียงต้องกลางทั้งเทียนแล้วก็ทำให้มีลักษณะเหมือนกับไม้กระดกพอสองข้างนี่มันไม่บาลานซ์นะเทียนด้านหนึ่งน้ำตาเทียนก็หยดลงมาก็ทำให้ได้น้ำหนักกว่ากลับไปกลับมา
Yeah so these were about 15-16 experiments that I have shown you these are only sample experiments this is not the full workshop our workshop goes for about 3 hours where the children are made to work there is a demonstration we have a group of 3-4 persons we mix in the children and children work in small groups you know this is a circular arrangement where children work sometimes children sit down whichever way we don't have a worry about classroom discipline because we are not conducting a classroom the main purpose is that children should learn by doing learning by doing is most important at the same time they should enjoy they should see that science as a fun and they should say this is what I have done this I is important no, I have done somebody else doing is of not much importance to the children so we have been doing this for as I told you almost for 2 decades as a voluntary activity and our experience is that students at any age we have done this for very young children in the kindergarten to the college students even the adults they enjoy conducting these activities themselves especially students enjoy because they hardly get any opportunity to perform experiments with their own hands in the school or at home parents say don't touch knife don't touch this don't open bottle give it to me I will do it how did you learn by doing you should do it unless you ride on a bicycle unless you fall down unless you have some wound somewhere you will not run how to you will not learn how to ride a bicycle okay so let the children do it but somehow in these days of parenting where you know earlier there were 5-6 children in a house so no one knew which class who is learning now there are only 1 or 2 children entire concentration on that one child and therefore not many opportunities are given they are given computers they are given video games they are given good clothes etc etc but very little opportunity to work by hand even if a child goes to the kitchen and say I want to prepare omelette the mother says don't do it I will do it for you no this experiential learning we have almost lost and I don't think your situation is different from our situation we are basically moving in the same boat you want to translate
yeah I forgot he talked so long but anyway
but actually, yeah, okay.
the main purpose is that sorry talking Thai จุดหลักสำคัญก็คือว่าต้องสอนแบบให้เด็กทดลองด้วยมือจริงนะไม่ใช่ว่าอันที่ห้ามทำนี่ห้ามทำนะแล้วเด็กไม่จะมารู้ยังมีก็ต้องบอกว่าต้องทำนี้นะให้ทำได้แต่ว่าต้องบอกเหมือนกันว่าไหนอันตรายไม่อันตรายนะก็มีโรงเรียนหนึ่งสมัยเมื่อก่อนผมเรียนที่จุฬามีโรงเรียนหนึ่งข้างๆจุฬาโรงเรียนอะไรเนี่ยนะฮะก็ต้องซื้อเครื่องเล่นวิดีโอเทปมาสมัยก่อนวิดีโอเทปไงแล้วก็เก็บโรงเรียนห้ามใช้อันนี้ห้ามใช้อันนี้เป็นของเดียวของเสียมแพงนะแต่ผู้ตรวจการกระทรวงไปตรวจปุ๊บเนี่ยจะเอาวิดีโอให้เขาดูปรากฏว่าลูกยางมันเสื่อมเพราะไม่ได้ใช้นะโอเคอย่างเงี้ยก็เป็นยกตัวอย่างให้ฟังว่ามันต้องใช้ให้เด็กรู้ว่าเป็นไงโอเค please
yeah so as I told you this is totally a voluntary activity so we do this on Sundays when the schools are closed we request the headmaster or teachers to see that the students come there There is in general a reluctance from the teachers to come on Sundays, but they help us to at least that the students come and we interact with students. And our interaction is more with directly with the students than with the teachers. And more importantly, one finds that these boys and girls, whoever they do activity, they want to carry it home. And therefore, the material used for one workshop cannot be used for the another workshop because it has gone. All those bags which we carry full into the workshop, they are empty when we come back. And they want to take it home. And because they want to show it to others that I have done this. Even a small activity, I have done it, is important. And then whatever point is, not only the school, the office goers, housewives, even college students are find this interesting. And there are now, we now get a lot of invitations from different groups to conduct these workshops. And we have been enjoying, you know, as I told you, it's our voluntary activity. We have been enjoying doing this. Ours is a group of 5-6 persons. And depending on who has a free time, we go to different places. And depending on who is the clientele, whether it's the young children, the adults, etc., we choose activities and conduct this. I hope the activities that I have shown would be of some help to you in teaching science. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Dr. Bhagwati, how about that? Workshop ma ต่างๆเนี่ยก็จัดมาเยอะเลยแต่ว่านี่เป็น